Hello, my name is Siley Jojin and I am a Senior Analytics Specialist SA at AWS. In this video, I will be showing you how to create and publish your product on AWS Data Exchange, also referred as ADX, using Amazon Redshift DataShare. For those who are new to Redshift, Amazon Redshift is a cloud data warehouse solution on AWS platform. RA3 is latest addition to Redshift's node types. RA3 node provides managed storage, which allows customers to scale storage and compute separately. These nodes are built on the AWS Nitro system and feature high bandwidth networking and performance. RA3 nodes support latest features on Amazon Redshift, such as data sharing and Aqua. Redshift's data sharing feature allows you to share live data across Redshift clusters for read purposes. One of the use cases for this feature is the ability to deliver data and analytics as a service across your organization. Data producers, also known as data sharing producers or data share producers, are clusters that you want to share data from. Data consumers are the clusters that receive data shares from producer clusters. Using the new ADX data share type on Redshift, you can now easily license access to your datasets. Data providers store the data on their Amazon Redshift cluster and can share specific data objects as part of their data product. Users that subscribe to the data products on ADX are added as consumers to the shared Redshift data share. Invoices are automatically generated and payments are centrally collected and automatically disbursed through AWS Marketplace Entitlement Service. In order to add ADX data shares to products, you must be a registered ADX data provider and your Redshift cluster needs to be encrypted. Next, you need to execute the 5 steps on this slide, which I will be showing you in the demo. So without further delay, let's move to the AWS console. Here I have a Redshift cluster that I've already created for this demo. Now we will go ahead and create a data share. First, let's connect to the database. Takes a few seconds to load any existing data shares. We will be creating one from scratch. So let's create a data share. And on this page, choose AWS Data Exchange data share type. Specify a name for your data share. And you can choose from any existing databases that you have on the cluster. Publicly accessible should be set to enable. And now we add data share objects. You can choose from available schemas. Here I'm choosing demo schema and I'm opting to share tables and views from the schema. Further, I can choose specific tables or views that I want to add to this data share. For the sake of this demo, I'm adding a single table, sales. Now I will go ahead and create this data share. Once the data share is created, now we go to the data shares tab from the left navigation console. And over here, I can see the data share that we just created. Now we need to authorize this data share for ADX. And with that single click, it's now authorized. Just making sure we have the right table. And now we go to the ADX console to create the data set and publish it on ADX. Here I choose Amazon Redshift data share and define my data set by providing it a name. And you can also provide a description for your data set so that your consumers can see this. Next, we will create a revision within this dataset. Now let's add the data share that we'd created on the Redshift cluster. So I'm going to choose the one that we just created and add it to the dataset. Last step is to finalize the revision. And with that, you have now created and published your dataset on ADX, which you can see under the owned datasets.
I hope you found this video helpful, and thank you for watching.